Between the year 2000 and 2006, the president of Tanzania, Jakaya Kikwete, ordered for the expulsion of over 50,000 people who were living along the Tanzania-Uganda border on allegations that these were refugees from Uganda, Rwanda, Burundi, and DRC. Whereas a portion of these people successfully settled in other countries, those who crossed Uganda are still living as refugees in various refugee camps across the country. Yofes Karugaba, one of the affected persons, reveals that the inhuman expulsion left a majority of them destitute.
Those people who are living at the border, they are living on the side of Uganda, but that area is razed. They are living in hilly places. Then they go down to have access on water. What these Tanzanians are doing, they send soldiers there and intercept their animals. And the charge that they put upon the animals too is really worse. Because one cow can be charged 150 Tanzanian shilling, and it is not even receipted. They cannot give it a receipt.
Karugaba explains how most of them gained Tanzanian citizenry, further insisting that President Jakaya Kikwete's order was illegal and in contravention of the East African Treaty on Human Rights of the East Africans.
We have been living in Tanzania for all that time, and some are Tanzanians, some are the ones who were looking for water and pastures. But of course, they went there through a process of law. They acquired documents. Then finally, others found themselves in Tanzania because of the border demarcation.
Yes. They belong nowhere. They are in concentration camps in Chebare,
Chaka 1, Chaka 2,
and others are scattered around the Western Uganda. If they are like to have neighbors, that's why they squat.
Through their lawyer, Mwesigwa Rukutana, the group has now petitioned the East African Court of Justice, seeking redress of their illegal and inhuman expulsion. In the petition, the group seeks a number of orders, as their lawyer, Mwesigwa Rukutana, explains.
Because under the treaty, the East African states, the partner states, are obliged to observe human rights of all the citizens in the region. They have failed, and we hold the two governments liable for not observing that cardinal provision of the treaty and so many other grounds.
Most of the people expelled had been born and raised in Tanzania, but upon expulsion, many have lost a sense of belonging, and many lost their animals, especially cattle. And efforts to get compensation from the Tanzanian government have been futile.